Hello again, it's Tim Spector of the Zoe Symptom Study app, giving you our weekly update as the UK slowly comes out of lockdown and spring is here and we're starting to enjoy life a little bit. The news is that the rates have continued to drop over the last week by around 18% or so, down to a level of around 1,600 new cases a day. And put this in perspective, that means roughly one in 1,900 people has symptomatic COVID at the moment, which is a far way from where we were back in January, when about one in 30 in some areas had the disease. And if we look at the map across Europe, we can see how we are mirroring exactly what's gone on in Israel, who are ahead of us in the vaccination race, and their levels are very low. Other countries in Europe that are behind us are still struggling to control it, although luckily a lot of those peaks seem to have passed in many of those countries. So we're doing pretty well relative to other places. And I believe that this fall from that peak in January is primarily due to our success in vaccination, not just locking down. Cases had already started to fall actually before the lockdown was announced. Certainly social distancing has helped get those levels down, but I think the fact we're now up to 60% vaccination, and we also have 5 or 10% of the population have natural immunity, is starting to give us this herd immunity that we were dreaming of perhaps a year ago as a quick fix. It's been a long journey there, but I think we should start to see this starting to kick in, which means that the virus itself is going to find it hard to really take hold, and outbreaks really shouldn't spread very far in the future. In terms of the vaccines themselves, a million of you have kindly given us all the details about your vaccines, your side effects, and whether you had reinfections or not, and very diligently getting tested when you get some symptoms, which is exactly what we need. And what we've found from your data is that if you've had not yet had a vaccination, your risk is higher than average. It's about one in 1,100. If you've had one shot and you waited that 12 days until it starts to work, your risk goes down to one in 5,100. And if you're lucky enough to have had two shots, your risk goes down to one in 15,000. Now, this is good news for those that are still worried by some of this data saying that no vaccine is 100% effective. It isn't, but it puts these risks into perspective. If you're someone who's still worried about shielding, etc., you can make your own mind up about what those risks are and put them into some sort of context. In terms of clots, that's still very much in the news as other countries start looking at the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which seems to be causing similar rare problems. We studied our data again, and we continue to look at it for clots. We did see clots in the data you gave us, but there's no difference in the rates between the AstraZeneca and the Pfizer vaccines, which tells us really that these are incredibly rare, because we know that it should only really be occurring in the AstraZeneca data. But we've only got 500,000 in each group, and that tells us that these rare manifestations really are very rare, one in 500,000 people. We'll keep monitoring that and let you know if we see anything else worrying, but so far so good. We are giving vaccine data back to you now. There's a vaccine report that's going out weekly, and you should be able to get that on the app and through email if you subscribe to us. So you can see yourself how many people are still getting infected after vaccines. And just as an example, there are 157 of you who have had some mild infection after that second vaccine shot. Luckily, they're all very mild, and that's reassuring. But that compares to 18,000 who are in the same time period have reported infections before getting vaccinated. Now, we're also now switching to looking for hotspots as we did last summer, because we expect rates to stay around this just over 1,000 people for a while, as young people will get infected, school kids, etc. We can't stop that at the moment, but hopefully it's not going to cause major problems to the NHS. We want to monitor it, as we are in Lambeth, where there's been an outbreak of South African variant, and to check that it doesn't spread or cause any other problems. I don't think it will, but this is a great use of the app and your data to reassure all of us. So I think it's generally good news. Thanks for logging all your information, getting tested when you need to, and continue to stay safe and enjoy life.